And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Lunar the Silver Star Story Complete. I'm your host, the RPG Guy, and we kicked the crap out of Mel, which was fun, because, you know, you're not supposed to be able to beat him. The game doesn't assume you would be strong enough to beat him, but they did have a contingency in case you didn't, and the game rewards you for trying at the cost of 400 gold, because that's what it cost for us to buy that. Now, what's interesting is we can actually buy starlights here for $1,000, so that idea can go screw itself. Because, yeah, that's really expensive for a really good item, in all fairness, but still really expensive. And also... we don't have enough money for that. It's not that we need to buy it, it's just an optional thing you may want to buy at some point. So we're in Maribia right now, we're trying to see if there's anything worth buying. So the stuff that we kind of ripped off of Nash earlier, you know, you can buy it here. We'll buy the armband, the steel armlet, wrist reflector, and then I didn't read these. Headband keeps forehead dry, robe, thick cloth wear. I need to remind me, guys, if I forget at certain points to read these descriptions, because they are pretty funny. Cast fireballs for archers on a budget. We already did this. But let's look at the new weapons Alex got really quick. The items I'm not that interested in because they're more telling you what it does, but broadsword, wide and wicked. Iron armor, fortified metal, iron shield, heavy and easily dented. Iron helmet, solid skull shield. It's one way to look at it, right? And then I think the items are just going to be descriptions. Yeah, these are just literal descriptions, except for rope not included. Why would the rope not have a, you know, why is the rope the only item that has a unique description? You'll find out in due course. And that's what happened. I still haven't determined if singing is the key. I have a strong suspicion that it is. And Nash, your friends have come. Alex, Luna, did you think to knock before entering? Well, it is a store. Why would we knock? Moron. Nash is descended from a line of morons. Morons, idiots, and retards. And remember, I say retard as not as a mentally handicapped person, but as just someone who's slow.
We seem to have guests, but I welcome those pursuing knowledge, as always. For you see, I am a student of knowledge, past, present, and future. I can foretell many things in the future. So, let's see your future. That's why you came to me today, isn't it?
Booberella. Booberelli, Booberelli, holy crap, it's Booberelli. We really didn't come to learn anything in particular. We were trying to find Nash.
Oh, really? From what I glimpse in your future, child, you need my services quite dearly. So many of the questions you have about yourself are ones that I could answer. And you, Alex, you seek to become the greatest hero our world has ever known. But you are too humble to be a dragon master. You are unwilling to choose power and glory over friends and family. This will be your undoing.
So it's my fortune, lady.
Licking your paws and coughing up hairballs, cat. It is an insult to think I would waste my energy looking into the future of a rodent.
I'm not a cat.
What the fuck are you then?
Alex, Luna, have you finished your tour of the city?
Having lived in the desolation of Kaldor Island, you two must be completely overwhelmed. I'm sure you'll adjust in time. And if you don't, I'll be that much more amused.
Nash, what were you asking the fortune teller about? Hoping she might know a spell to cure bad hair days?
You rude little rodent. In fact, I asked her, it's none of your business anyway, is it?
Ooh, I know what it is. You asked her to see if there's a woman in your future. Nash wants a girlfriend. Good luck, Tiger.
Alright, so we're done dicking around with that. Let's keep moving. Hey, nani nani, and a ho ho ho. Diddly 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 diddly. Hummina 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 hummina. Lord of the goddamn Mahominum.
You can understand, this is a dragon diamond, freshly minted from Quark's mighty keister. He doesn't just give these away to just anyone, you know.
How am I supposed to know if this is genuine dragon diamond? We've had the devil of a time with the dragon zirconium lately. It seems like we've got a fool in here every day claiming to have a genuine dragon diamond. But I will admit this one is the most beautiful gemstone I've ever seen.
Sounds like shit's going down.
Hey, Alex, did you meet with Master Mel? I'm still negotiating this guy to buy the diamond, but I might have to settle for a lot less than it's worth. I'm sorry.
Like I've been telling you, young man, this is a wonderful stone. But the Dragon Doryman, sorry, no. No one even knows where to find diamond the dragons anymore, much less how to get dragons' diamonds from them.
Right. So how much will you give it for it?
For a diamond of this caliber, I'd give you 20,000 silver for it, and that is my one and only offer.
It's your decision, Alex. It's your decision too, Alex. What do we do?
I think we can get more.
Is that right, young man? Well, you are welcome to look around, but you're not going to find a store that can offer half as much as me. I'm the richest jeweler in bloody Moribia, mate.
Okay, so we have to actually agree to his terms. So this will just start it back up again. My offer is 20,000 for your lovely diamond. Before he changes his mind. The price is right.
Excellent. I'll go into the back and get your money. Hand over the diamond so I can put it into my safe. Wait here, please.
Come on, guys. You know how this is going to go down.
I didn't realize it took so long to cut out 20,000 silver, Alex. Maybe it's too heavy for him to carry it all out here at once.
Fishy.
Alex, something's wrong. Dross, hello, where are you? Alex, Ramus, Dross is gone and so is the dragon diamond. We've been had.
Please don't hurt me. I just started working here. I don't know anything. I don't know anyone. Why don't you go talk to Master Mel? Maybe he could help you.
This is all my fault, Alex. I should have known Dross was a con from the start. I got cocky because I was able to catch Brett. I'm so sorry.
Alright, so we gotta go talk to Master Mel. But on a lighter note, we can equip Ramus if we want to. We don't necessarily have to, but we might want to see if we can give him any kind of armor. I don't think he can actually equip any. Oh, yeah, he can. We do want to give him some gear. The catch is look at how expensive it is. Even the cheap stuff we can't really afford. Do we have actually anything to sell? Yeah, we do. We sell that for 30 bucks. We can sell this sword for another 100. Because, yeah, he's just not going to do it. So what we're going to do is instead of armor for Ramus, we'll get him a bow. I think he can use the new bow. Fingers, toes, and testicles crossed, I think he can use the new bow. Don't ask how I cross the testicles. It's very painful, and I start singing soprano for about 3 minutes. All right, yes, he can equip it. So, but we're broke. All because I had to buy the soap without the rope. And you can't get a lot of money back for it, so. Yeah, I'm willing to sell some herbs for that, because, you know, killing things before they kill you is a better deal. So we'll buy this, and we'll equip it to Ramus, sell off his old one. And we won't have enough money, really, for a piece of armor, but that's okay. For now, that's okay. We will take care of that in due time, because we've got another small little section to deal with. I meant to give that there. And when I say section to deal with, it's more along the lines of It's more along the lines of, I don't know why I did that, but it's more along the lines of grinding again. It's another short section. So let me give you an example here. We're technically caught up leveling-wise. The game is, we might be just maybe one level over where the game kind of wants you to be. I know that sounds really weird, okay, because the idea is that that last dungeon we were in, they expect you to kind of run through it twice-ish if you really want, but really the best way to level up, as you're going to see coming up here, is this next dungeon is a great little place to level up pretty big, pretty crazily or heavily. And the other thing too coming up is that you have some options of how to handle certain aspects of the various things coming in and going on. So before we talk to Mel, I'm going to take care of one little thing we can do. I believe we can do it. There is... I went the wrong way. I believe we can go... Okay, so never mind. We can't get in there yet. We'll get in there in a second. But a lot of people forget to do that, and I just want to make sure I do it as soon as possible, because if I don't, chances are I may forget later.
So, lad, what's on your mind? We were trying to sell our diamond to the man named Dross, but he stole it. If I've said it once, I've said it 100 times, that Dross is a crook. But if it's your fault too, you can't just hand over a valuable jewel like that. Since you're trying to become adventurous, I think I'll let you solve this one on your own. Test your strength, but trust your heart, lad. All you can do, all you can truly rely on is yourself.
So, yeah, that's the thing. I believe... I believe now we should be able to get access. Now, that's not the entrance you would normally go to chase Dross. Nor will it get you to Dross. Unless you somehow hack the game or something. Okay, then we'll have to wait till later. We get access to that entrance at some point. I just forget when. Because there's a couple of chests that we can't get unless we go in from there. So, again, we're not going to worry about it. If we can't get it now, we'll get into it now. There's always later. There will be a distinct time later when I know we can. I just don't remember the earliest time we get access to it. So, we'll go back into Dross's shop. That's not a chest you can open, by the way. It does not open. Though it's Dross's shop, we should be allowed to rip him off since he ripped us off. Alright, so... into the back room we go. I have been scoping out Dross's store for weeks, coming up with the perfect plan to rob him blind. Then I stumbled upon this secret passage in the sewers. I decided today was the day to pull the job, so I hid here and waited. And Dross runs past me clutching the biggest diamond I've ever seen. I had a sewage worker alibi ready, but he was so happy with the giant jewel he didn't even notice me. This day has just been so weird that I just had to tell someone about it.
Alex, this guy's a thief. Shouldn't we tell someone about him?
We don't have time, though. The longer we stay here, the bigger the draft gets with our diamond.
Fat bastard. So, we are in another large dungeon. And the problem with this large dungeon, as neat as it is that it's got lots of nasties in it. Lots of different enemy types, too. And these enemies are harder than anything we've fought before. And they have more variation than anything we've fought before. So, you kind of have to be a little careful down here. You'll notice we can't kill... You know, Alex cannot kill a single one of these enemies by himself. And these are the weakest enemies in this dungeon, give or take. I believe there's technically one weaker. But you can see they hit pretty hard. They're hitting Ramus really hard because we just don't have the means or the money to make him a little better at his dealio here. So that's going to be a little problematic. But we'll make do. The goal would be really is to get armor for Ramus, because he's obviously going to need it if he wants to survive here. The other thing that's going to be important, too, is we get 108 silver a battle. That's not bad. 100 silver for the weak, for arguably one of the weaker battles. Now, I should be more specific. One of the weaker battles here isn't bad. But we are going to have to deal with Ramus getting smacked around a lot. And the fact that he just doesn't have enough armor to resist some of these weaker enemies means we're going to have to get him a set. And, you know, it's 600 bucks for the freaking, what is it? Oh, there we go. It's 600 bucks for the, over 600 bucks for the the chest piece of armor. So that's just that. That doesn't include the shield and the helmet that we're going to have to buy as well. So we're going to need easily around 1,000 silver. So we're going to have to level up a bit. Unnecessarily, but a little bit. Because, yeah, it's just we're going to be leveling while grabbing money. Specifically silver. Now, if we would have had that extra 1,000 silver from Berg, it probably wouldn't. We wouldn't be hurting for that money. And I screwed that up. But I don't remember that being a thing. You know, I thought it was. Maybe it's in a different version of the game. Like the PSP version. But, yeah, you're kind of left. Yeah, we need to fill him all the way up. You're kind of left to your own devices on that. But I am going to show you some of this dungeon. Since we are going to explore it a little bit just to get either some chests or some other stuff. There's a chest down there. There's also some secret passageways in here, like I think this. Yep. That'll get us a starlight. We could sell a starlight for, like, I think we get, like, 400 gold or silver. There's no gold in this game. Silver for it. So if you want to burn that kind of, you know, a starlight, you can if you really need the cash. But you have to remember, too, even Alex, with the best weapon available to him, he's not dishing out damage like he was before. Okay, so the game is literally caught up to us. The fact I'm killing him this quickly is obviously because we're using explosion staff. That's the only reason we're killing him as quickly as we are. So that's suggestive, that's something subjective, that's something completely different, another starlight. And we need to stockpile these bad boys as much as we can, and only use them when we absolutely have to. There's no reason whatsoever to use them unnecessarily. But see, here's the other thing, too, is I believe as Ramus levels up, he's going to stop getting as 8 HP. Or it's going to be like every other level or something like that. So his growth literally is going to start slowing down to nothing, which is bad. Because he's just going to be dead weight. And trust me, he's carrying a lot of weight. Come on, you knew I was going there. And so we're going to have to deal with that to some degree. Now, this is the interesting little area where you can grind. The actual way through is through the center thing, but you got to set it up a different way. And you'll see that little fireball is arguably the most dangerous enemy down here, give or take. They hit the hardest. They're the easiest to, probably the easiest to kill, but they hit the hardest, and so that in turn makes them the most dangerous. The fish enemies are not too bad. They group up pretty well. They don't poison you, I don't believe, so that's usually a nice touch. And we could also use Luna's sleeping skill if we were really that concerned. Since I'm not that concerned, you know, we might in these larger battles with these dudes. I think they come in groups, yeah, like this. Whereas if we use, we don't have it, but I think we can only hit three of them with that attack. So this would be a good battle as an example for Luna to Tranquil, what is it? Temptation Song. Because, yeah, Alex, I don't think will kill one of these. Oh, yeah, he will, but it takes two hits. So the Temptation Song will help. Again, when Alex is one-shotting enemies again to some degree, this isn't such a big deal. But for this, at this moment, it's kind of bad. Kill. Let's see how much XP we get from this massive fish battle. I am curious. And you can see the fish move faster than Ramus does, and they do 25 damage. That's, again, his lack of armor. And we're just going to have to deal with that. And pretty much what that means is we're going to let Luna burn out of MP before we run back up to the surface. But 56, 287 silver. So this is really the fight to get money. It's like doing two fights kind of in one. And so, yeah. So here's what I'm going to do, guys. I'm going to get us the money we need. I might do a little bit of light grinding. And then when we come back, we'll be down here. I'm probably going to have all the fish enemies, what are they called? Fatal hoppers. I'll probably have all these fatal hoppers murdered. And probably all the other enemies killed and stuff. You saw all we got here. We're going to come back here. Ramus will be geared up. We might be a level, maybe two higher. I might try to build up a level or two before we press on. Try to keep our characters above make sure our characters constantly have a little bit of an edge going for us. So we'll be back in a little bit with some new gear and some new strength. Alright, so we leveled up to 15. I pressed the button over there by going through this walkway of fish. I forgot to show me doing that. I apologize. I was looking for more enemies to fight and found out that that was an issue. So, alright, let's keep moving. And we'll get us a delicious herb. You know, I was over here fighting enemies just to see what it'd be like, and, you know. And we get some new enemies. Now, because of the situation here, we're probably going to use the starlight at some point. But you definitely don't want to be taking damage from this many enemies. So we'll use the explosion staff. Because, yeah, that he'll take out three of those fireball dudes in one go. And when the little roly-poly dude's kind of rolled up like that, you want to take him out right away. He's not doing the roll-up thing. When he does an attack that hits pretty much all characters on the screen for pretty massive damage. So if I need to use a starlight when we get further down, that's just going to be the way it goes. It's not something I'm ultimately worried about. I wonder if there's a shortcut, but I don't think there is. We'll figure it out when we get down there, but one starlight's not going to ruin the day. Oh, wait a minute, hold on. And the goal is to try not to use any of Luna's healing magic. We want to hold on to as much of that as possible. And we're going to run into a lot of enemy fights we could probably maneuver around. There's going to be a better place to build up levels. This area probably isn't it for various reasons. Number one, those eyeballs are like me at a hometown buffet for the breakfast bar. But we're kind of trapped in there now, so we either going to fight them or we're going to just deal with it. Yeah, we're going to fight them. And this is probably the worst battle setup. Well, I think this is the attack we need to be weary of. It's just a bad deal all around here. We're going to take a lot of damage this round, unfortunately. But I went and bought some herbs just in case this scenario would play out this way. Because, yeah, the dude's going to go. We're going to get hit with Spin Rush because I went after the wrong one like an idiot. So that happened. And he didn't die. Great. Yeah, that's not good for Alex there. Let's see what happens. Alex should be able to... Yeah, okay. So Alex can kill the snakes in one hit, but that's about where he draws the line. He's not able to do that. He's going to go get knocked out. Now, I did look into this. It happened while I was leveling. Luna got knocked out, and the battle still raged on, and everybody still got XP even when they're knocked out, it seems. So they just get respawned at the end of the battle at one health. Sometimes in the middle of a fight, Gnaw will come in and wake up an unconscious character at 1 HP, so you're just hoping he doesn't get knocked down again. And you hope you can get a healing out, pull off a healing spell or whatever you need. So yeah, that happened. Luckily, we've got a few healing herbs here. I should have probably got more, but I didn't. Not like I was hurting for money. I didn't need to use one there, really. And Ramus, he's got his armor bonuses, but he's not really going to be taking that much less damage. You're really just kind of hoping for this. As you can see, we're just going to plow our way across this little thin bridge here. Because screw these bad guys. They're a little much. Because, yeah, Alex isn't killing them in one hit. And the only things he can kill in one hit are the snake dudes. And so that's really the best thing for him to really be focusing on. Ooh, he got critted twice.
Harsh.
So yeah, it's just this little area of enemies is kind of weird and kind of rough, and you're just gonna have to deal with it. The XP isn't that great either. This is only 30 XP. We were getting 40 from the, we're getting over 40 I think from the fish dudes, and they were a lot less of a threat. So it's one of those things that's very subjective. Is this a good area to grind? And you kind of have to deal with what's coming up, but it's just really subjective issues with the enemies here hitting you rather hard. So as you can see, Dross is over there hiding in a corner. A starlight and a couple antidotes here. And so here's what we're going to do. We're going to reorganize some inventory. Actually, no, we don't need to. We're actually good. We might need to use a starlight in battle. We'll worry about that when we get there. We may not. Chances 90% sure we're going to have to use one. Which is fine. It's completely fine. This is one of the earliest times in the game where you may need to use one, regardless of what's going on. And there's nothing wrong with using one in this upcoming scenario here.
Yeah, you are, thief. Give us back our diamond. Now!
I don't know how you kids found me, but it doesn't matter. Because you won't be around long enough to find your way back out. Here, boy, that's it over here.
And there's the stuff of nightmares. You know, people complain about alligators in the sewers, but when you see dragons in the sewer, that's when you know you're fucked.
Yeah, that's what is it?
Surprise, kids, I'm pretty amazed myself. I never knew my little pet would grow so quickly down here.
Or that he'd come in then so handy, or that he'd come in so handy for getting rid of annoyances like you.
Get ready, Alex. This pet looks like he's hungry.
And all you using the intimidate talk doesn't really pan out all that well. So, like many boss fights you will see us do in the future, we're always gonna start with vigor. We're always gonna put up Cascade Song, and really, as much as Ramus could attack, we're gonna have him defend and hide in the corner here. His attack is so pathetic, it's not worth it. So what's his point in this battle? What's his function? To throw out a healing item or cure poison as needed. That is his function. He has no other purpose, he has no other function, for he is Ramus and he is fat. Alright, so attack, and you know what? We could have him attack now that he's in the back. I mean, if you're really worried about him taking damage, just have him defend the whole fight. He's not your primary source of damage. As you can see, 11 damage is pretty sad. And the dragon's usually gonna focus 90% of his effort on Alex. So in this case, obviously Alex is gonna do that, Luna's gonna do that, and Ramus is gonna do that to keep the HP high. He probably did a little overkill with that, but that's just the way it's gonna go. So he's got two more sword dances left. Yeah, 58, and you saw how much damage he took from the fire breath. And Luna's gonna take a hit, but I don't think he can hit the other characters with that fire breath, so we should be relatively safe from harm. It's just that neck reach attack you gotta worry about. The other thing, too, is using regular sword melee attacks doesn't really work on this guy, so you kinda need that sword dance thing. I'm just gonna say, because when he's that far back on the battlefield, you don't have access to getting to him. So you're kind of up the creek without a paddle, as they say. This is a part where Ramus is going to come in and throw out an antidote. Again, everything we can do to keep Alex alive and strong. And the next round, Luna's going to throw out her starlight. And then we're going to have Ramus use our herb, but we're in a weird position. So I lied. We're going to have Alex use his, because we need to make sure he gets healed before the dragon gets an attack. If you want to call this a dragon, it's, you know. Compared to the dragons we're supposed to be befriending, this is a bit of a dragon. So now, as you can see, the starlight recovered Alex's MP a bit. Let's go with the tranquil song. That way multiple characters get delicious healing. You can see this boss is pretty tough. That fireball attack's pretty rough, and Alex is wearing something that actually reduces fire damage. He's wearing that fire ring. So, I mean,
he's taking reduced damage, and he's still taking a crap ton of fire damage. And that's kind of just the way that that plays out. So you see we're doubling down with the healing item just to be safe. But we should only have to do this for 2 to 3 more rounds, and then it'll be done. Give or take. He uses magical fire press to save the maidens there. What would Brian Boitano do if he was here right now? I'm sure he'd whip this ass real soon. That's what Brian Boitano would do. La, 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 la. I would have laughed, though, if Ramus did kill him right there. You can see he's spamming the crap out of that fire press attack. The heal should be enough. Did I actually heal, or did I do something else? And it's not going to matter. So Alex Party wins, 250 XP, no levels, because, yeah, our HP is pretty high. Our XP is pretty high, requirement-wise.
We can talk about this. Hey, you kids are getting dangerously close to invading my personal space. Okay, okay, this is all the money I have. Take it, it's yours.
500 silver.
500 silver, we agreed on a lot more than that, Russ. Hey, I have an idea. You own your shop, don't you?
Of course I do. So what?
Because now I own it, Ross, in exchange for the diamond. That's a fair deal, right?
Sure it is. So I guess I'll be leaving with the diamond then.
What do you mean? I sold the diamond to the shop. And since I own the shop, I own the diamond. If you don't agree with my logic, we can keep you down here until you realize how much sense it makes.
We get the dragon diamond.
Ramus, I know you've never heard these ways before, so I'll be gentle. You are the man!
You are! Because I think everyone deserves a second chance, Droth. I'll give you a gem. But if I ever, ever catch you trying to scam someone again, you are so fired.
And in Ramus' terms, when he fires somebody, he cooks them on an open fire and then consumes them.
Thank you so much. I'm turning over a new leaf. Nothing but honest work for me from now on. I'll return to my your shop and start waxing the floors.
I know I can't trust him, but he can teach me all he knows about the business. Then I'll fire him.
Ramus, you're totally ruthless. You're going to be a great businessman.
I'm so proud of you, Ramus. Let's get out of here and take a look around your new store.
Ramus, don't tell me you're starting to like it down here.
Alex, forget it. You can keep my half of the money, Alex. Having the shop is more than enough.
Let's continue this conversation above ground. I need fresh air and I need it now.
Fuck! Look out, kids, it's a ninja!
Oh, yes, there's no doubt about it now, is there? She's the one. And we're still having fun, cause she's the one.
Now, before we do anything, go to get Ramus. I'm gonna call him Gandalf for a second. And, go give. There. I believe, Nall does have a limit, but so you notice we've emptied out Ramus hardcore. So let's go ahead and I purchased a second one just so I don't have to purchase another one later. Let's go ahead and use a dragonfly wing to get out of dodge. We collected everything down here, I believe, like 99% sure. But you did see some chests. And those chests are from the other entrance that I showed you earlier that I, for some reason, we couldn't get in. We couldn't get into yet, so it's whatever. We'll get it figured out later.
Thank you again, Ramus, for showing mercy on me. Oh, I almost forgot. There's someone here to see you.
You're back. Excellent.
Okay. I heard about your journey through the sewers to find the diamond, and now you killed a dozen monsters along the way. You may not have any magical abilities, Alex, but you're still very strong. Strong enough to come to Vayne with me. I'll introduce you to Galleon and get you into some classes at the Magic Guild. Think about it, Alex. You could finally learn to use magic.
Alex, this is an imposter. We all know that real Nash would never praise someone other than himself.
Would you please let me finish, Cat?
Thank you.
As I was saying, Alex, despite your dubious choice in bets, I enjoy your company, and I can see the enormous potential within you. The Magic Guild is always looking for people like us, people who want to take their potential and turn it into skill. And if you come to the Guild, you'll meet Galleon and Lemia, two of the four heroes, Alex, two of the people who fought alongside Dragon Master Dine. They may even be able to tell you more about the dragons.
What should we do, Alex? Go with Nash or go home?
Don't look at me, Alex. This is your life and your choice. But I promise to follow you no matter where you go.
Alright, let's check out the guild. Excellent. Alex, you won't regret this decision. We should depart for Vayne immediately.
Me. Well, I'm going to stay here in Meribia. Magic is way beyond my grasp. And I've definitely had my fill of nearly getting killed by giant monsters. Besides, I'm a businessman now, and I'd be too busy remodeling the store to go anywhere. Alex, promise me you'll keep having great adventures. Remus, you have to come with us. We'll miss you.
I'm sorry, though, but I've already made up my mind.
It's just not going to be the same without you to make fun of.
And no, that was something that was really there.
Take care, Remus. Good luck.
And hey, it's not like we'll never see each other again. I want you guys to stop by the store whenever you're in town. Thank you, Alex. Thank you for everything.
Sometimes a fat dude down on his luck just needs a little push from his friends.
Off a cliff.
I mean, somebody's like, damn, man, you're really digging into them fat jokes on this guy. Well, I'm a fat dude myself, and I take pride in my jelly rolls.
Let me see that jelly roll. Let me see that jelly roll. Jelly roll, jelly roll, jelly roll, jelly roll.
So Nash is now in our party, for better and for worse.
Fuck you, Nash. I'll be dying of fire.
So here's the deal regarding Nash to some degree. I don't think the store sells anything yet. Yeah, it doesn't sell anything yet. We took Nash's armor away from him. If you can actually remember that. I don't know if you guys remember when we did that, but it was hilarious. And we're still not going to give it back to him. But here's the deal. First things foist. We're going to sell off Ramus's old crappy gear. So goodbye, battle bow, armor, shield, and helmet. So think of those items as rentals, because that's really what we did. We also have too many antidotes to worry about. We only need like four in this inventory, and that's you only need them in battle, so it's like, I don't even throw them out there on my character, so we could go with less, but I'm just going to sell the few that we have right now and keep a few just in case. And like I said, with Nash, I'm not giving him anything. I'm not giving him any gear. I'm not going to waste time giving him anything of really any value or any interest. There's really just no need. In all fairness, so this is one of those things where it's like meh. We don't need to equip him with anything. So, and Alex, it'll make sense as we progress forward why we're not going to do that. Why we're not going to invest in him right now. I know it seems weird, but we're all, you know, I'm trying to nickel and dime as much as I can here because we did waste that 1,000 silver. I swear that mom gave you 1,000 silver. Unless, it, like I said, unless it's a different version of the game, which is very, very likely, and I just, you know, don't remember what sequence you have to talk to her in to get it. So, double check, guys, if that's really a thing, or what version of the game offers that, because, like I said, I don't remember for the life of me. Okay, so now we can go down in here, and I don't think there's any enemies. If there is, it's only one or two. It could just be a snake. Yeah, I think, yeah. And it's nothing we obviously can't handle. With murder! And we have Nash with us, to whom I will say he's an upgrade from, what's his name? And Nash is fast. He's going to be faster than Alex in most cases. You'll also notice his level is still pathetically 12. Not much we can do about that, but don't worry. It'll correct itself in due course, of course. Where was this guy, you know, earlier? You know, that would have really made that other area a lot easier to get through.
Let him hang back.
Not that we need to conserve MP right now, but whatever. And I don't know what his 2 next level is, but I'm pretty sure he's got some ways to go. And that's just kind of the way it is. 180, so he'll level, Luna will level, Alex and Luna will level, and then he'll level, you know, after Luna does. So yeah, there's a few enemies down here, so what can I say? Guess there was more than I thought. But, like I said, we have magic on our side, so that really kind of evens the issues out here to a degree. Now this is interesting, because he can't reach everything. So, yeah, we could open with... No, it wouldn't. We wouldn't be opening with that. So let's just do this for now. You could try Petrify, but again, it's subjective. It doesn't really work that often, if at all. And you have to remember, Nash isn't wearing a lot of armor, so he's very, 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 very vulnerable. So making sure that we keep these enemies away from him will be paramount to his overall survival, but nothing so bad that we're going to sit there and go, oh my god, he's going to get his face smashed. He could level pretty soon, too. If we really wanted to take him into the sewers, we could, but meh. You really only care about Alex's. In the grand scheme of things, your biggest concern is Alex's current level. Nothing else really matters that much. And now that we have magic, we have other means to deal with these enemies. So we will exploit that. Look at that. That AoE is going to be nice. It's a shame we couldn't get it off earlier, though.
Check this out.
Yeah, Alex sometimes goes first. Most of the time, Nash should be able to get in there before the others do. It seemed that that did not work. So, here's what I'm going to do, guys, so you guys don't have to sit and watch me, you know, get my face smashed in. No. Jokes aside, we should be okay. But I will fight all the enemies in the area.
Check this out.
Kind of knock them out, because they're all the same enemy configurations we've literally already fought. So I don't see that much interest for you guys to sit around and wait while I clear this place out and grab treasure. And definitely give Nash some wanted XP, I guess. Got a healing nut out of the deal, too, so it's not a total loss. And Alex leveled up. Range increased. Always good. Always good when he gets that range increase, which means Luna is about 110 or so XP away from leveling herself. 60, never mind, and 96. So, yeah, Nash will probably level once down here while we kind of loot the dump. I mean, this wonderful, wonderful place. But here's what I'm going to try to do. Instead of cutting away, what I'll try to do, we'll make our way, let me make our way down to that little room where the treasure is, and then we'll clean out this area separately. So we'll do this. Luna can do that. Ash can do that. Because Thunder Bomb and Explode. This is another way to quickly get through these fights if you really want to. Kerbloom!
Yeah!
It may not kill the dude in the. Yeah, it did. I wasn't sure if it was going to kill the creature in the center. So that's another tactic to quickly take him out if you are comfortable burning through your MP. Again, it's not something I'm that keen on, but meh. We got one or two more dudes, and then we should be down at the bottom. And then, like I said, I'll come back through here, clean out the area. If the enemies have respawned, we'll deal with it. If not, we'll just warp out. There's so many options of what we can do. So, again, nothing major really comes to mind. So,
check this out.
And the next dungeon's kind of odd. So you might think, oh, stock up on healing items. You can hold off on stocking up on healing items, I assure you. Because there's going to be some weird stuff that goes down with that. And Luna levels, yay! Which means Nash will level pretty soon, so we'll at least get him a level out of doing this. Weird that they wouldn't let you come down here to begin with, though. He's at 12 to level. Okay. And you can see you can also come down from the side here. Woo, look at him! Holy crap, it's still chasing me! Jeez. So yeah, I don't think there's another chest in that area, in that vicinity, so don't worry about it. Let's power through this as best as we can.
Check this out!
Flash! Oh! You see, he didn't kill anything, though. For shame, Nash. You had one job. think he'll... yeah, he will. Got some physical attack in there. Nowhere near as good as the other characters, but still works. And Nash levels, yay! Awesome. Let's keep moving. I could be wrong on the characters meeting the level of the main character. Oops. Circle is not the menu. Circle is not the menu. Say this to myself 10 more times and I'll get it right eventually. And this should take us to the room here. Yeah. So there's a starlight. There's a red chest, so when we have access to those.
Yay.
The fortune ring. You can give that to anybody, really, without it meaning all that much. Where is it? Here it is. So, like, let's take out... Healing herb from Alex here. Fortune ring right now. Eventually this will go on. The fortune ring will go on someone else, but... Increases defense by 1 and luck by 10, so... Since Alex is going to get most of the thwarting, you know, most of the hits to the face, that is the best deal for him. By far. Best deal. Now, we could warp out of here. What is this? Yeah, 443. There's no point in picking fights with enemies like this that are given... when we could go to a place where and get more XP. So, let's head on out. We'll buy another Dragon Wing. We'll always make sure you got one. There's eventually going to be a point in a time where you don't need that. And if I missed a chest or something, eh, well. I think we'll be okay. Pretty sure we've so far collected every chest that had an item in it. I'm not including the ones that lure in flies, though. The killer flies from the other area. So we're going to heal up. We could buy a better staff for Nash, but again, save your money. Save the money. We're not going to need it. So you notice Nash can kind of take care of himself with his magic abilities. So, and then really quick, looking at the spells, where it says 1A, 1 ally, 1 ally, 1 ally, area of effect, all allies. And then if you look at Nash's, this is how the magic works. Easy, enemy zone. So kind of like how Alex uses his explosion staff. It's just a small zone that he encompasses when he does it. And so you can hit multiple enemies with these spells. But you're hoping that confusion kicks in and turn to stone kicks in. And they don't always do. So you're better off just doing raw damage. Unless Nash's magic would do nothing at all. And even then, it's debatable that there are better options for him to do other stuff. So anyway, this is a great place for us to stop, guys. When we come back, we're going to be heading to the Magic City of Vayne. Sounds like a wonderful place. It's not. Well, it is. It depends on how you look at it. It's kind of cool, but it'll be up to you guys to decide, because you're going to get to see it when we get there. Thank you guys for stopping by. I'm your host, the RPG Guy. Like, comment, and subscribe. We will see you guys next time. Bye!
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Please take a moment to check out more episodes from the RPG Guy, Tuesday Night Team Up, and more. And please subscribe. Always support the channels you enjoy watching, and while you're at it, follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Keep on gaming hard. See you next time.